हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर शिल्पा राउत फ्रॉम केके वाक कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक एंजाइम, दैट इज डीएनए लाइगेज। दिस इज मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज्ड एंजाइम फॉर द जॉइनिंग ऑफ द डीएनए स्ट्रैंड्स। डीएनए लाइगेज कैटलाइजेस द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फॉस्फोडाइस्टर बॉन्ड बिटवीन 5' फॉस्फेट ऑफ वन स्ट्रैंड ऑफ डीएनए और आरएनए एंड 3' हाइड्रोक्सिल ऑफ अनादर। फॉस्फेट ग्रुप फ्रॉम 5' एंड ऑफ वन स्टैंड अटैच विद द हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप ऑफ द 3' एंड ऑफ अनादर स्टैंड एंड देर इज अ जॉइनिंग ऑफ टू स्टैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ फॉस्फोडाइस्टरेज बॉन्ड। दिस एंजाइम इज यूज्ड टू कोवेलेंटली लिंक और लाइगेट फ्रैगमेंट ऑफ डीएनए टुगेदर। द डीएनए लाइगेज used in molecular cloning differs in their abilities to ligate non-canonical substrate such as blunt end duplex DNA-RNA hybrid or single strand DNAs. This is the example of DNA ligase, that is the T7 DNA ligase. We'll see the mechanism of DNA ligase. The mechanism of DNA ligase is to form two covalent phosphodiester bond between 3' hydroxyl end of one nucleotide with 5' phosphate end of another. Then for this bond formation, ATP is required for the ligase reaction, which proceed in a 3 steps. In first step, adenylation of residue in an active center of the enzyme, then pyrophosphate is released, then transfer of the AMP to 5' phosphate, so called donor, and formation of pyrophosphate bond. Okay, means within the first step, adenylation is there, means addition of AMP is there at the active center of the enzyme. Then pyrophosphate is released from the system, and transfer of the AMP to 5' phosphate, so called the donor formation of pyrophosphate bond. Then formation of the phosphodiesterase bond between 5' end of the donor and the 3' hydroxy of the acceptor. If you see this diagram, 3' end consists of hydroxyl group, and this 5' end consists of the phosphate group, and there is a formation of the phosphodiesterase bond by addition of the enzyme DNA ligase. And after this process, there is a formation of phosphodiester bond in between these 2 strands of the DNA. Depending on the source of enzyme required, either ATP or NAD used as the cofactor for the joining purpose. Then unit of the enzyme activity for all the ligases. One base unit is amount of enzyme required to convert 1 mole of radiolabeled phosphate from pyrophosphate into absorbable material in 20 minutes at 37 degree centigrade under standard assay condition. One base unit equal to about 67 cohesive end ligation unit. Then we'll see the different example of this ligase enzyme. Bacteriophage T4 DNA ligase. The most widely used DNA ligase is derived from the T4 bacteriophage. That's why it is known as the bacteriophage T4 DNA ligase. It is monomeric polypeptide having a molecular weight 68 kilodalton. is encoded by the bacteriophage E gene 30. It has a broader specificity and repair single stranded nicks in duplex DNA RNA and DNA RNA hybrid. This is the diagrammatic presentation. Then application of this enzyme, ligation of the cohesive end, ligation of blunt end, termini. This reaction is much slower than the ligation of sticky end, and ligation is improved by addition of monovalent cation and low concentration of PEG. Then ligation of synthetic linker or adapter to the DNA molecule. This is the example of blunt ends and this is the example of sticky ends. Okay, in case of sticky end, some single stranded overhangs are there, but in case of blunt end, both the part or both the system are in the form of double stranded, but in case of sticky end, some part is of single stranded. And then there is a joining and formation of the double stranded DNA. The next enzyme is the E. coli DNA ligase, is derived from E. coli cell and requires NAD as a cofactor. It is a monomeric enzyme with molecular weight 74 kilodalton, which catalyzes the formation of phosphodiester bond in duplex DNA containing cohesive end. This enzyme has a narrower substrate specificity, making it a useful tool in a specific application. Application of this enzyme: ligation of cohesive ends. E. coli DNA ligase used to catalyze sticky end ligation. Then cloning of full length cDNA, that is the complementary DNA. E. coli DNA ligase has been employed in a procedure for high efficiency cloning of full length cDNA. Then third ligase enzyme is TAC DNA ligase. The gene encoding thermostable ligase have been identified from several thermophilic bacteria. Several of these ligase have been cloned and expressed to high level in E. coli. It uses in a detection of mutation as thermostable DNA ligase, retain their activities after exposure to higher temperature for multiple rounds. It is used in DNA amplification reaction to detect mutation in a mammalian DNA. Then T4 RNA ligase is the only phased RNA ligase that has been extensively characterized and used in genetic engineering. This enzyme catalyzes the phosphodiester bond formation of RNA molecule with hydrolysis of ATP. It is monomeric enzyme with 373 reduced amino acid residue, is a product of T4 gene 63. Then application: production of elongated molecules, then modification of internal nucleotides, then stimulation of T4 DNA ligase activity. Okay, this is all about the DNA ligase along with its different example. Thank you.